of the debugger, but this is the ExtendScript debugger for Visual Studio Code. It is an extension for Visual Studio Code that enables you to debug ExtendScript. It supports all of the standard contexts that ExtendScript runs in. That means if you run a JavaScript from some of the host applications, I think Photoshop has that, script UI contexts, which is supported in some of the host applications, and CEP extensions, which it's the common extensibility platform, not UXP, but CEP, which has a browser context, which is standard, you know, Chrome, JavaScript, and then there's the ExtendScript side, and those two talk to each other. So this is the ExtendScript side. This enables debugging of that. It also has facilities for compiling to JSX bin if you need it. Okay, so let's do a quick demo just to so that we can see what it's all about. I have Premiere Pro up and running right here, and I have to switch back to my VS Code. But effectively, I have this little Who Am I script here, and I have the extension installed under the extensions view. I'm going to come in here to run and debug. You'll see I don't have a launch configuration set just yet. But what I'm going to do with a breakpoint set right here, I'm just going to add that. I'm going to click run and debug. I'm going to launch it. And this is, since this is a file and it's not just a file buffer, just a, an unsaved text file, I can launch instead of attach. But this Adobe Premiere Pro, I'm going to click that and it's going to connect. And now I have all my variables for this context. And if we watch down here, we have app name and app version, which because these are vars, they were added at, up there. They're currently undefined. But if I step through, we'll see that they get updated. We get the Premiere Pro there. Okay. And then we get the app version. It's going to say 24. And then I can step over to the alert and boom, I get the alert. So that is sort of the basic. And, you know, once it completed, it ended, the thing went away. You'll see here that we did get some debug output in the debug console. Yeah, so that's effectively the basic idea about the debugger. It lets you run your, debug your scripts and see what's going on as you run them. So let's talk a little bit really quickly about what the extension doesn't do. If you're familiar with the ExtendScript toolkit, the old application that supported ExtendScript debugging, what I just showed in Visual Studio Code, there were some other features that ExtendScript Toolkit, ESTK, supported that the new extension for Visual Studio Code does not support. Specifically, profiling support, which was the ability for you to say, I want to profile this function, and it would show you how much time it took to run. The object model viewer, which would provide you with a way to browse the data, the DOM, the data object model, of the host, a connected host application like Premiere Pro, InDesign, whatever. That does not exist in this extension, unfortunately. And it also doesn't support auto-completion, things like IntelliSense. That is supported by the Visual Studio Code sort of language services built in. Luckily, there are tools out there, this types for Adobe sort of community-provided set of their type declarations. They work with TypeScript. But they allow you to, they enable Visual Studio Code to show you, you know, hints, it says inline documentation where it's supported, that kind of thing. So I'd recommend going in to check out this so you can sort of combine this with the ExtendScript debugger to get some of those features back. Okay, where to get the extension? The extension is called the ExtendScript debugger, and it can be found in two places. One is the extensions menu, which is sort of that menu I showed in the demo. You can just search for ExtendScript debugger. It should show up. And also at Microsoft's extensions marketplace. And that's at the link below. You can just sort of Google for ExtendScript debugger extension, and it should show up in your favorite search engine. Okay. And for next steps, I cannot recommend highly enough that you check out the README, which is either on the page or if you click on the extension in the extension view within Visual Studio Code, there's a big write-up with everything about options and how to use it and what attach versus launch means and quirks about working with different host applications because ExtendScript is complex and they operate differently with different host applications. All that is documented in the README. And if that is a little bit much for you, Chris wrote a fantastic guide at this link here. Check it out. It's fantastic. Great write-up. And we'll hopefully get you in quickly and moving in your debugging journey.